Becoming a mother is a beautiful and overwhelming thing. It is important for women to feel safe and secure while on this journey. Many mothers have had to go on this journey of motherhood during the coronavirus pandemic, and they have handled the situation gracefully. At MediCircle, we present to you the National Safe Motherhood Day Awareness Series, wherein we are featuring successful mompreneurs, healthcare professionals, obstetricians, gynecologists, entrepreneurs working on safe motherhood to raise awareness about the adequate access to care during pregnancy, childbirth, and postnatal services. Hi, I'm Smita Kumar, your host, and today our guest for the talk is Dr. Rashi Agarwal. Dr. Rashi is the director of Praxis Healthcare, which is a hospital management consultancy firm that provides integrated solutions for all healthcare business requirements. She's also the founder and director of Treatment Overseas, which provides medical tourism services. She has experience of over a decade as a director in various healthcare organizations. Hi, Dr. Rashi, welcome to MediCircle.
Hi, Smita. Thank you for having me on your series. And it's been a pleasure. I mean, we've had a chit chat and it's good to know about what you have been doing in the last entire year. I'm excited to be on your series today.
Great to have you here because you are a successful mompreneur having two beautiful kids and a good firm which is actually going to hit India. I mean, with helping India with the more and more hospitals and consultancy services, because every here in India, everyone is talking about only two things. One is education. The second thing is healthcare.
Healthcare.
So I wish you for all the best for this endeavor of yours. And to begin this question, I would be asking you, there are six pillars of safe motherhood, Dr. Rashi, including family planning, then antenatal care, obstetric care, postnatal care, and post-abortal care. Also the control of STI, HIV, and AIDS. In your view, how we can ensure safe motherhood?
So there are a lot of ways of, having a safe pregnancy. But before even you reach the stage of pregnancy, I think it's important to give importance to your planning stages. The minute a woman gets married and decides that she wants to conceive a child, she should start. Ideally, a woman should just take care of herself irrespective, whether planning or not planning. But at these times, it becomes even more important to put emphasis on your personal body and, take charge of your own personal body so that you can have a safe pregnancy, have a good life post-pregnancy so that you're not attacked by the entire gamut of complications during pregnancy, post-pregnancy, and you can have a healthier life and a healthier baby. So it's important to put a lot of emphasis on your own diet, your vitamins that you're taking in, your exercise, your daily regime. I mean, just living a healthy life, having a healthy mind and body is important, physically as well as mentally. You have to be in a good space physically and mentally to have a safe pregnancy and give rise to a healthy baby. So of course, as I said, exercise is one of the key things. Your eating, food habits, good nutritious diet, taking all your rainbow diet, as they say. So a good mix of vegetables, fruits, fresh food, balancing of proteins, carbs, and all of that. Apart from that, a good vitamin balance. So having your antenatal vitamins is important. Folic acid is very important during your pregnancy. So your folic acid intake, your other vitamins, your B complexes, D's and C's and everything, the entire vitamin plate. These three things have to be followed. Apart from that, of course, when you're planning or you're not planning, you need to decide whether you're planning or not planning. So age is something that you need to take care of, not having a baby too early on, within the right birth period, when you're not too old as well and not too young as well. So between 20 and say 35 is a good bracket to have a baby, not too early on. Having a first child before 30 is ideal, but of course, today the kind of life that we live in, that's not always possible, but having a first child before 30 is a good way to, it's a good biological rhythm to follow. And the later you have children, it can even give rise to complications of cancer later on. Your breast cancer chances and all increase as you have children later on in life. So planning at the right age, safe, using contraception if you're not planning. for like we talked about STDs, so as for STD, HIVs, and so of course safe sex, and you know, all of these things put together, you can basically plan, eat well, diet, mentally be calm, have a good sleep pattern. So good 8 hours minimum of sleep in a day, exercise. All these are key things to kind of take care of having a safe pregnancy.
Surely, as I mean, we are getting more and more competitive. I think one thing where the every woman is compromising is the age when she's having the first child, I think. But it is really important to have your first child in that right time, because otherwise, not just the women, not just the mother, but the baby would be also having a lot of complications.
Yes, absolutely.
So, Dr. Rashi, moving on to the next one, like women who are pregnant for the first time, because as they don't have much knowledge, if they are having their people to take care, like mother or mother-in-laws, there are still better chances of knowing and understanding things. So, but still there are some common ailments that are associated with pregnancy that they should be knowing. What is your view on that?
So I think, I mean, you know, you have to first treat pregnancy as a normal phenomena. It's not a disease. So it has to be treated like a normal phenomena where you do your normal chores, do your normal things, but of course nothing overdone is correct. So, I mean, your mother-in-law is always going to tell you eat, but eating the right diet is important. You know, you can't be just eating your ghees and laddus and all of that. You have to eat. Of course, that is important as well. Your dry fruits are important, but you don't have to load it with the heavy ghee in it. So eating the right diet is very important, as I said, and gaining the right amount of weight is important. So you should not get suddenly just obese. You know, you can't gain like 20, 30 kilos in your pregnancy. Between 10 and 15 kilos is appropriate. It's like, you know, 10 to 12 kilos is just ideal. You should not try and just go on eating and gain excessive weight. Again, exercise is key. People tell you don't lift this up, don't do this, sit carefully. No, it's a normal thing. So you do your normal thing, whatever your body is used to, you can continue doing it, but you can't suddenly do something that your body is not used to. So as long as your body is used to walking 60 minutes a day, continue doing that. But suddenly you can't start doing something you're not used to. People are used to doing exercise. I know people who have been like, you know, gym instructors. They're used to doing gymming. You know? They're used to heavy lifting. They're used to all of that. So if their body is used to it, you can continue doing that in pregnancy also. There is no such thing that you cannot. Right exercises, of course, help. So, you know, they say basically sweeping, mopping, all that also, the duck walk, all of them are great in the third trimester. So they work very beautifully. Your antenatal care, basically your prenatal care. So what is the prenatal care entail? It basically entails these kind of exercises. So your Kegels exercises, very good for making your pelvic floor strong. Your pelvic muscles become really strong with the Kegel exercises, which you don't really need to do it consciously. Even if you're doing it in the car, sitting in the car, it's okay because it's basically breathing and holding, releasing. So that can be done anytime, any place. Yes. So these basic things that you keep in mind and you keep doing, it kind of leads to a good, healthy pregnancy. I'm sorry, but if I'm, it's something that you can repeat the question. So I'm losing something. I don't know what, just repeat the question.
There are some common ailments that are associated with the pregnancy. Yes. So again, so, like many people have this morning sickness.
Morning sickness is very common. You know, peeing a lot. People have constipation. People have piles. So morning sickness can also become a gravida situation where you're just MSS gravida, it's called clinically, where it's excessive vomiting. So these kind of things you need to be careful about. But a usual morning sickness is very, very, very normal. So normally, like, you know, we say clinically that if you just keep two biscuits on your bedside and before you wake up, before you get out of your bed, if you just take those two biscuits and put in your mouth, like a two Parle G biscuits mainly, put that into your mouth before you get out of bed, it will help you a lot with your morning sickness. So it kind of gives a lot of relief. So these are some basic things that you need to, you know, follow. What you're liking to eat, your dislikes and dislikes of your food preferences may change. And hypertension is one of a common ailment during pregnancy. So that is one thing you need to be careful about. You know, preeclampsia, eclampsia, these are things that you need to be careful about. So monitor your blood pressure regularly. Gestational diabetes can be something that you need to be careful about. You don't want to suddenly land up with any kind of blood sugar ailments. So exercise, again, as I said, is important so that you don't land up with any kind of, you know, I mean, of course, if you're prone to it, you're prone to it. But these are some things that if you're mobile and you're using your mobile and you're doing your exercise, it's going to prevent it.
Sure.
So, yeah.
So one thing on the warning steps, like there are a lot of warning signs during pregnancy that a woman should not neglect and immediately report to her gynecologist.
Yes. Something like, you know,
yes, please.
Vaginal bleeding. Vaginal bleeding is something that you have to immediately report. These are any kind of bleeding that you may have or any kind of headaches that you may get with blurred vision. Then you should report immediately. If you're feeling the movements of the baby are restricted and you know you can't feel the baby movements, that has to be reported. Abdominal cramps, uncontrollable abdominal cramps, then very bad backaches, fever, convulsions. Yes. These are things that you cannot ignore. You have to report them immediately. But mild morning sickness is not something you would worry about. Of course, excessive vomiting you need to report, but mild stuff is okay.
One thing, as you are a mompreneur yourself, and what are the winning strategies for balancing work and kids? Because you have many mompreneurs face this condition where they are on balancing the family life, both kids have to be raised, and also the business has to be taken care of. So how do you do this?
I think the basic thing is a good support system. You have to make your own support system because you can't neglect your kids and you can't neglect work. I mean, you are raising both. Both are your babies. So you have to be able to trust people around you. You have to be able to build a good support system. And the women around you are your best support system. So whether it is your mother, your mother-in-law, your sister-in-law, your girlfriends or whoever it is, you know, building a good support system is important and having being able to trust them. So, and you have to ask for help. So nobody's going to come out and help you directly. You have to reach out to people.
Charlie. So like whenever you are having any problems, you must reach out to especially first your family who may support you in such a case.
Absolutely.
Because it's really difficult. Sometimes it is not a cakewalk. Even Ami, I'm having two beautiful children, and sometimes I feel that I just should bang my head.
Overwhelmed.
because my younger son, he is very naughty. So sometimes it becomes like where I need to concentrate and am I doing 100%? And sometimes there shouldn't be any guilt also. See, if you're
if you're guilty, you can never work, and then you're not doing justice to either. Yes. So you have to be able to work guilt free so that you do justice to both. Yes. And it's quality time rather than quantity time, I would say. So if you are being able to give that quality time, then, and again, the spouse has to help. So you have to have the right balance in both the parents also to kind of take over and when one is missing or out or whatever. And it's been a challenging year, of course, with the schools being shut, because otherwise a large part of the day goes with school. So that's been definitely a challenge. But you have to kind of, earlier I could carry my kids to the clinic, into the office. So now with
an option, yeah, actually sometimes.
Now that is also not an option. So, I mean, earlier I had their set of toys and educational stuff, you know, in my office and stuff, which I mean, that worked well as well. But now that is also not an option. So, yes. But yes, you got to do what you got to do.
So thank you so much, Dr. Rashi, for sharing such significant information with our viewers today. It was a pleasure having you with us on the show. We definitely believe that MediCircle, as a dedicated healthcare media platform, through such initiatives, is able to educate and aware more and more people about safe motherhood. And also, if you are having a working woman in your home, do support her, because it's not her journey alone. You have to support her to actually make India healthy, and also, I mean, a woman, a country with most of working women and having beautiful lives, because women is actually the center of the family. So once again, Dr. Rashi, thanks for joining MediCircle.